Hello and welcome to Alice in the Wonderland. So today I wanted to talk about honesty. What is a white lie? Do you know white lies? An unimportant lie, especially one to be tactful or polite. I think, for example, if I do a comedy show and it doesn't go well, I want people to tell me a white lie. You know, I want somebody to say, no, you were great. The audience was really difficult. You know, I don't want to say like, no, actually you were shit, because I will do that myself anyway. So I need somebody to white lie to me, please. So please, yes, please, please. The thing is also, for example, when you, I don't know, let's assume somebody goes on a date and you spend the night together and then you have something, whatever this is, and then the person asks you, what are you thinking? What can I think after I just had sex and I lie in bed? Lampshades and light bulbs. You lie in bed, you look up, right? You look up, what do you think of? Light bulbs. The question, what are you thinking, forces you into lying. You don't want people to know what you're thinking. Ideally, you think, oh, I think that was amazing. Oh, ho. The thing with light bulbs and lampshades is that some light bulbs could be really artsy. Some lampshades could be artsy, and therefore sometimes people just have light bulbs there, but it looks almost like a lampshade. Do you know what I mean? And then I'm thinking like, oh, this person is really artsy. But maybe this person is not artsy, but just lazy and forgot to put their lampshade there. And then I think, oh, is that person lazy or... You know what I mean? And sometimes I just think about my bank card, because my bank card, my English bank card, has quite a funny number. It amuses me if I think of the PIN code of my bank card, because I'm just like, ah, oh, that's a funny number. Then when I start thinking about my English bank card with the funny number, I immediately think about my Austrian bank card with a number that I always forget. It's a very difficult number. It's also four letters or numbers, not letters. But I always forget that. And then I have to write my mom. I'm just like, oh, mom, I forgot my number again. She has a folder where she keeps all my details, like my date of birth, and my credit card numbers. She forgets things too. I don't know why she keeps them, actually. She's probably the worst person in the world to keep my backup. But she's better with me. She forgets only her own things. My mom is really scared of, you know, of... How do you say, like, of people listening and of people cracking emails and codes? And so she never replies to that email with that number. She always sends a separate email to a different email address with a different subject line and tells me a story to send me then the number. The problem with that is just that I am in the middle of something else, and then suddenly I get this email from my mother, totally out of context. One mother has 7 children. 3 of them wear skirts and 2 shoes. And I have forgot that I've asked her for the PIN code. And I think my mom got mad. So I wrote her back, who is this one mother with the 7 children? And what am I supposed to do? Should I send some shoes, or do you want skirts? I don't know. What is happening, mom? I don't understand. No, Alice, that is your PIN, 1732. I always say, come back to the tongue twister. If the thought I thought had been the thought I thought, I wouldn't have thought I thought. I always say that now when somebody asks me, what are you thinking? Oh no, that's my bank card again. When you press double, then the bank card comes up. I don't know. 4 colors of lie. I can't believe it. What? There is a red lie. Oh my God. My world has just opened up. A red lie is a statement told with complete awareness that the other person knows the statement to be false. Ha! I get a positive benefit is a black lie. I get a positive benefit and other get a positive benefit is a gray lie. Hello, gray lies are good. Most of the lies we tell are gray lies. They are partly to help others and partly to help ourselves. They may vary in the shade of gray. Oh, the 50 shades of gray. So if you comfort myself and tell me I have done a great show, then better lie if it was not a great show. if it was a great show, then don't lie and tell me it was a great show. Basically, just always tell me it's a great show. Yeah, so let me know what you think about lies and don't lie, unless it benefits us both. That is my conclusion of this vlog. That is a very good thought-through vlog this week, I know. Thank you very much. Let's keep on lying. I think that's it. See you soon. Bye!